Hello, welcome to Baby Boomer Tales. My name is Jim. You can find us at babyboomertales.com. There are links to YouTube, Facebook, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and several others. Thank you for being with me today. I hope I make you feel welcome. The title of our episode is My 29 All-Time Favorite Music Songs, Volume 2. On episode 21, we had Volume 1 of my 29 All-Time Favorite Music Songs. And I realized after I published that podcast that you just can't have 29 favorite songs. There's too much music with too many memories, too many things that are associated in your life with a certain song. So we may start an annual event of 29 favorite music songs. These are in no particular order. When I realized I wanted to do another volume of these songs, I just took out an old yellow legal pad, let it lay on my desk. When I run across a song I really, really liked and maybe it put to the back of my memory or something, I'd write it down. And so this has been going on for several months now, and I finally came up with 29 of them. It's really not hard to come up with 29 songs, but you want your 29 favorite. That's what I did last time in episode 21, my 29 favorite. So these are my 29 all-time favorite music songs, volume 2. Number 1, Sukiyaki by Kayu Sakamoto, 1961. The name Sukiyaki was strictly Americanized. It was I Look Up As I Walk. Very sad song. If you YouTube it, get the one with the English translation on it. It's a beautiful, haunting, sad, make you want to cry song. And the guy did it so well. What a beautiful rendition of a thing that isn't even from my culture that I can associate with that. It's an amazing song. Number 2, by Whitney Houston, in 1992. Now, in 1973, Dolly Parton first recorded it, and she wrote it. It was in 1982, part of the soundtrack of The Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. I Will Always Love You. It was part of The Bodyguard, that movie with Kevin Costner and Whitney Houston. Whitney was quite a talent. She could really sing. Number 3, recorded in 1968 by Dion. It was a very timely song back then. Abraham, Martin, and John. Touching on the lives and the deaths of Abraham Lincoln, Martin Luther King, John F. Kennedy, and Bobby Kennedy. Number 4, by Bob Dylan, recorded in 1963. I knew I needed a Bob Dylan song in there. I didn't have one last time, I don't believe. So I started thinking about him, and I could have had 29 Bob Dylan songs easily. But I couldn't do that in the spirit of shaking it up and having a variety of different types of music, genres of music, different artists. Girl from the North Country. Number 5. I Can't Help Falling in Love with You. Elvis Presley. 1961. Number 6. Recorded in 1968. By Janis Joplin and the Holding Company. Peace of My Heart. Number 7. By America. Ventura Highway. Recorded in 1972. We went and saw those guys about 3 or 4 months ago. Now, Dan Peek, one of the original members, three-piece band there, has passed on, but they still have the same spirit of America, and it was a great, great concert. Glen Campbell, 1967, Gentle on My Mind. Probably one of the best guitar players I've ever known about. Old Glenn. What a wonderful song. you listen to the words. In 1982, there was a guy named Jay Unger, and he wrote a song called Ashaken Farewell. And it was used as the main song in the documentary by Ken Burns called The Civil War. Haunting and sad. I was surprised when I looked it up that it wasn't a piece of music from the 1800s. It really feels that way. Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, 1970. Our House. Our House is a very, very, very fine house. With two cats in the yard. Or in my case, several cats and a couple dogs. Judy Collins in 1969. Someday Soon. Talking about someday soon, she's going with this guy. And her daddy can't stand him because he rides the rodeo. I would think if that song was made in 2020, she'd say, my daddy's relieved that I like a cowboy. 1956. It's a traditional Jamaican folk song. It was recorded by Harry Belafonte called The Banana Boat. Its original title is Day-O, The Banana Boat Song. Day-O. Remember Day-O? Boy, Belafonte did that song well. Daylight come and I want to go home. 1968, A Beautiful Morning by the Rascals. 1967, by the Monkees, Daydream Believer, Old Sleepy Jean. 1964, John Sebastian, The Lovin' Spoonful, Do You Believe in Magic? One song that I think resonates with everybody, saying it's okay, you can sit back, you can just laze around a little. Nothing's that important that this isn't part of your day. Otis Redding sang it, Dock of the Bay, 1968. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Percy Sledge in 1966 sang When a Man Loves a Woman. I think in 1966 I didn't even know what love was. But I knew one thing. I knew when I fell in love, this song would be at the heart of it. Remember Noel Paul Stuckey, part of Peter, Paul, and Mary? In 1971, he recorded a song that was played at almost every wedding for years and years and years. It was titled, The Wedding Song, There's Love. Man Should Leave His Mother. When my dad died, the funeral, they played a song that I had never heard before, never even heard of the artist. His name was Paul Overstreet. And the song was Seeing My Father and Me. That resonated so much in my very soul. There are two songs in this life, and the other was on my first volume of 29 Favorite Songs, that take me right to my dad every time. It is this one, Seeing My Father and Me, and one by Dan Fogelberg, the leader of the band. It's funny how music can take you to a loved one and put you right there. And every time you hear that song, I don't care if you listen to it every day, it puts you right there. It put me right there at the funeral. It put me right there at my dad's knee when I was a little kid. It put me right there when I was helping him on his farm and working in his grocery store. These days, I see my father and me big time. Sometimes I wish I'd see a little bit more of my mother, but that's okay. I know she's in there too. Mr. Bojangles, 1970 by the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. His dog up and died. After 20 years, he still grieved. You ever have a dog that affected you like that? That's where my mother comes in with me. I've had a dog like that. I always held on to cars and houses and friends and dogs, just like my mom. I don't know if anybody ever watches American Idol, but one year I was watching it, and all of a sudden they had a guest artist, you know how they come on and play a song they're probably trying to promote, been released. And this girl dressed like I Dream of Jeannie came out, started singing with this other guy, and she started doing a belly dance and her hips, and it was, her name was Shakira. The song was Hips Don't Lie. And I don't think my wife much likes her, but I, from that, I guess first impressions are everything. I've always liked Shakira. Her and Wyclef Jean. I'm not even sure I say his name right. But that is quite the song. My Hips Don't Lie. Toby Mac used to be of DC Talk. He's been a solo artist for years now. On one of his later albums, there's a song called Lights Shine Bright. It's about the light you have everywhere you go. That light within you. How does it shine? It's a wonderful song. I really like it. Michael W. Smith, Friends, 1987. Friends are friends forever. Number 24, Carole King from 1971. You've Got a Friend. Number 25, her buddy James Taylor from 1970, Fire and Rain. Probably the saddest song I've ever heard in my life. I remember the very first time I heard it. Who's Suzanne? Man, who is this guy singing this? 1961. It's number 26 on the list. Patsy Cline, I Fall to Pieces. Probably one of the most classic of classic country songs ever was. Miss Cline's life got snuffed out way too early. Johnny Cash from 1956, and he's another one. I could add a whole paper full of Johnny Cash songs. Number 27 on our list, I Walk the Line. Dolly Parton, in 1971, released a song that's associated with her childhood. I think a lot of her music takes her back to times back there in the mountains. Poor little girl growing up. Coat of Many Colors. There's a television movie about this very thing. It's a wonderful movie, and the little girl that plays Dolly as a child is just great. She really nailed it, I think. It's worth watching if you've never seen it. And number 29 on my 29 All-Time Favorite Music Songs, Volume 2, I couldn't go a whole list without a group called The Beatles on it. There again, I could put 29 Beatles songs on here. Just lickety-split right off the top of my head. Wouldn't even have to think about it. But this one's kind of special to me, as the last episode, Volume 1 of the 29 songs was. That song was In My Life. Well, this song, number 29 on today's list, from 1964 off the album A Hard Day's Night, And I Love Her. I wish I could just sit and play those songs for you on this, but there's certain things I have to abide by, and plus we don't have the time for it. I have many of these on playlists because they mean a great deal to me, and I'd like to be able to get to them quickly. Some of them I watch on YouTube, like Sukiyaki, so I can see the spirit of the guy that is singing it. His facial expression. So when he says that he walks with his head up high, it's so that the tears that he's crying don't fall to the ground. And he touches his face right under his eye ever so lightly. I think of all the mediums in life, words, television, movies, books, music. The music affects a person in a way the other mediums cannot even begin to approach them. I know my songs are different than your songs, and that's a good thing. There are certain types of music I do not care for, and there's other types, and you could probably tell by my list, that I hold dear in my life. But one thing's for certain, as you grow older, you think your music was the best music ever made. If your folks are alive, just ask them, and they'll tell you something like Tommy Dorsey or Glenn Miller. There's no doubt about it. Always be kind, no matter what. I'll be back next Wednesday.